Hello and welcome to Trojan Talk. I'm your host, Aaron Taylor. My guest today is Pike County native and world-renowned artist, Nall Hollis. Nall, thanks for joining me here today.
Well, thank you for having me here. I'm thrilled to be back in Troy.
Now let's talk a little bit about one of your most recent pieces. That's the topic and the subject is well known to people in this area, and that's Rosa Parks.
Yes.
And let's talk a little bit about this piece and how it came about.
Well, how it came about is being from Alabama and Rosa's story being from Alabama, it was obligatory that they would coincide one day or another. So let's just say that the future held the meeting. Already, you know, it was like destiny that mm-hmm. this would happen. Is representing probably all of the people in Alabama. If you've been in Alabama for four generations, all four grandparents were born here. And one of my grandparents was racially educated, as most people in Alabama were. Mm-hmm. One was a racist, one was not a racist. My father, having black Native American blood and German blood, was a racist because he was taught to be a racist, but he didn't realize he was being a racist against himself. Mm. And I think that's so true with different races in Alabama. We're all mongrels. We're all a mixture of everything because we're Americans. And if we've been here a long time, we've had enough time for the races to blend in together.
And now that kind of comes through in the piece. And that eventually, some of the stories and things you're telling the story of Rosa Parks.
Well, having experienced the injustice mm-hmm. and the horror.
Oh, yeah. Like,
what can we do? Mm-hmm. We accept the commission. Mm-hmm. And so I'm an emotional artist.
Oh,
so
not a problem
this
with
will
that.
Happen probably several times, no matter what we talk about.
Yeah.
But it's like, I feel that touching the problem that we have as human beings of accepting who we are and then learning to love who we are was a deep-rooted necessity for everybody to be able to breathe comfortable air. It's like seeing the whole history of the United States being unveiled. I read a book years ago, the Real History of the United States or something like that, and I was shocked to learn all these things that it was printed. And why didn't we get those books when we were kids? So to be able to work on this was a passion. It was a passion of justice.
And some of the elements of it, in the picture, we're seeing pieces of magazines.
Magazines, I had to find photographs of Rosa. And so I ordered these National Geographic magazines for children. And I would just go through these, and it was just wonderful to find all these faces. I had done portraits for Alabama Southern Community College of Martin Luther King, Truman Capote, mm-hmm. all these subjects that were related. It was just like, let me go back into that passionate world of work, because when you're painting flowers for wealthy clients to eat, because that's how I eat, mm-hmm. I sell paintings. I don't inherit. I've always lived from my art since I started painting outside of college. In fact, even as a student, some of the galleries in Paris would say, oh, well, this is the model that models at the Beaux-Arts. Come back when you do professional work. I said, this will be professional in 50 years or less, because I did it, and that's all I do. And I intend to continue living from my artwork, so you want to sell it or not. And so about 6 months later, they would say, we'll take it now, and they would sell it and have sellout shows. But it's like growing up as an artist and growing up as an uncomfortable racist raised on the white side of the fence was a burden that I didn't want to carry. So I went to France to escape. and found the same thing over there. I thought the French would say these wonderful things in French instead of what you have for breakfast, bald. You had pancakes or biscuits, did you put any gravy on it? And the French were saying the same things, but not knowing what they were saying, I could imagine that they were talking about Marcel Proust and all the other writers.
We've run out of time for this segment, but yeah. and knowing that you kind of come full circle to this point and know that this is how the artworks kind of started and how it's come to this point, I want to thank you for joining us today for telling us this wonderful story. Thank you.
Yeah.
And thank you for joining us on today's edition of Trojan Talk.